श्रेष्ठ, ओवर टू यू।
थैंक्स डॉक्टर मनोज। थैंक यू अनुपम एंड मनोज फॉर आस्किंग मी टू गिव अ टॉक हियर। सो सर्टेनली आई एम नॉट एन एक्सपर्ट इन द एरिया, बट आई एम एक्साइटेड टू लर्न समथिंग एंड डिस्कस इट विद पीपल। एंड एज फार एज वर्ल्ड मैप्स आर कंसर्न, जस्ट कपल ऑफ ईयर्स अगो, 2-3 ईयर्स अगो, आई स्टार्टेड एक्सप्लोरिंग सर्टेन मैप्स, नेमली पावर मैप्स with Anupam, and that's how I became excited. And Goto's method is something which I learned recently, so I thought that with some young participants here I will discuss what Goto's method is and what kind of variants people have recently used, recently meaning 5-6 years ago, used to prove certain results on world maps on SU. So maybe I should first write the references here, the main references of the talk. So I'll seek pardon from the experts, because this will mostly be expository talk where I'll just be discussing the main result and kind of methods which are there in this paper. This paper is many of the experts will already know all these methods. These are so Elka Sapi and Tom, they have used this method, and this is Indiana Journal, and the year I guess is 2014. So this is one of the references. And well, maybe I should have said even as a zeroth reference, maybe zeroth reference should be Goto's paper. So I had just browsed through that paper. It's quite old. This is 1949, and this is in Journal of Mathematical Society of Japan. So Journal of Math Society of Japan, that's 1949. And those who may be aware of the content of this, this is somewhat before Orr's work. So this talks about special kinds of words, commutator words, and this is somewhat before, well, almost contemporary to Orr, slightly before perhaps. And few more references which I should add. Maybe this nice survey article by Gordiev, Kunalski, and Plotkin. So this must be, so from archive I took, so this is 2018. So this is on the Plotkin's 90th birthday, I guess. And so another context in which Goto's method was used was for angel words, which is nicely surveyed in this second article. So that is Gordiev. This is Journal of Algebra, 2015, perhaps. Yeah, 2015. So these are the basic reference for today. And I said I'm not an expert, but I'm learning things. And I was thinking about power maps, and then I thought what could be other methods, and I started searching things, and this is how it is. Okay, so with those references, let's get to the basics. So what we have is a free group on number of generators, D generators, and quite often for our purpose, D is equal to 2 is good case. So D is equal to 2 is quite good case for our purpose. So any element in a free group of rank D is going to be called a word. And of course, a word is going to look like this. So these Xi ones, Xi twos, Xik, they are one of the elements of the generating set of the free group. Xijs are one of the Xis, X1, X2, Xd, and Nis are integers, positive, negative. So this is how a word looks like, an element in the free group. And like the way we evaluate polynomials, we can also evaluate words. So you can evaluate a word on a D tuple. A word can be evaluated on a D tuple. So you pick D many copies and do the group operations as per the Gi1s, Gi2s determined by the word. So you did do this operation. So if you have, for example, power word, which is x1 to the power m, you just say g going to g to the power m, right? So that is how a word map is there. So I'll confuse. So I'll use the same notation for a word map and for a word. So word and word map, the same notation W, which I will be using. And I will be misusing some notation also, because image of G cross G, D many copies under the word map, I will simply say WG. The image of G is just WG. So that's somewhat misuse of notation, but not very significant. So for example, I can worry about what are mth powers, what are commutators, because mth powers, commutators, those are examples of words. So that is what I'm interested in. And these things are subsets of G, of course. And the questions which we usually have in this kind of area is, for example, how large is N? So as such, large may not have any significant meaning, particularly when your group is infinite. But in some context, maybe we can try to put the meaning to how large is this. And particularly for finite groups, well, even for other groups, we can talk about width of the group with respect to this set. So width meaning, given an element, what's the smallest number of elements from the image which is required to express that given element? So if for all elements you can express, for example, in terms of 2, 3, 4, so that 2, 3, 4 would be the width. So this could be like varying type problem. So something like it's a product of how many nth powers, right? So those are varying type problems. And another line of thought is how large are the fibers? So you pick an element in the image and see what are all possibilities of G1, G2, GT, GD. So how large is the set, which is a pre-image of a given element? So how large are the fibers? These could be general questions. So all this is very general basic thing about word maps. And of course, and this is an insignificant remark, but yes. So there is no magical trick. Everything depends on the choice of your word and the group. So a lot depends on that. And there are extensively studied examples. So commutator word, which is x1, x2, x1 inverse, x2 inverse. It's a common example, which has been studied now for last 70 years. And power maps, of course, and particularly when people are interested in varying type problem. Yeah, so this is just a warm up. And yeah, okay. So some interesting things, which are natural things, like what kind of groups, well, sorry, not groups, what kind of sets of G appear as images? So these are trivial observations. Identity always has to be in the image. Identity is always in the image because you can choose 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and whatever word you substitute it, it's going to be there. And second thing is WG is actually union of conjugacy classes. Right, that is again not very difficult to see. Yes, some cancellations may happen, so you can pick the conjugate elements in G1, G2, GD, and certain cancellations would happen. So this is also not very difficult. And in fact, you don't really require cancellations. It's an automorphism. So you take any automorphism, and the image is invariant under automorphism as well. So these three properties are there for the image. And there is an interesting article by Lebotsky, which says that if your group is finite and simple, for finite and simple groups, if you pick any subset which is having identity and which is odd invariant, then for a suitable choice of word, you can think of that set. So any set which is having identity, which is automorphism G invariant, you can obtain it as G, as the image of a suitable word. And this is very, very special situation, because you are working in finite simple groups. And what he uses very heavily is two generation, in fact, what is called 3x2 generation of finite simple groups. So that's, but it's quite interesting. But of course, the W that he constructs is very huge in some sense. But anyway, this kind of result is there. So this is just for the initial survey. And another kind of theorems which have been there in the area. So this is a reasonably recent, just 2-3 year old paper of Gralnik, Liebeck, O'Brien, Shalev, and Tape. And this is kind of this interesting that one interesting consequence of this is the classical Burnside's theorem of solubility of groups. Any group of this order is solvable. So what it says is that you take any finite simple group, of course non-abelian, any finite simple group if you take, and then if in the prime factorization of n there are at most two primes, then x1 to the power n times x2 to the power n, that is a surjective map. Yeah. So like people were in the beginning, they were even trying for second power and all that. But now it's much more general that not only that in a finite simple group, every element is a product of two squares, but it's actually product of any two nth powers where n is having at most two primes in its factorization. So this is again, in fact, very, very, I would say, very hard work, say 100 pages and all that. And it's for students, maybe some of them may try to derive that it's actually, one of the corollary is Burnside's PQ theorem. Of course, you don't need this to prove Burnside's PQ theorem, but it's for fun, yeah. Okay, so this is one direction, right? This is one direction where people are thinking about finite simple groups and words on finite simple groups. And other things could be not for finite groups, but for arbitrary, say, algebraic groups. And in that direction, and say algebraic groups over complex numbers, of course. So one of the, not initial, but yeah, one of the results in that direction is interesting, but perhaps not very, very useful for some practical purposes. So this is Borel's theorem, which says that word maps actually are dominant. They are dominant maps as maps of variety. So G cross G cross G to G, the word map as a morphism of varieties, it's dominant for connected semi-simple groups. Yeah, and as a consequence, one can actually obtain that for semi-simple connected algebraic groups, you have that every element of the group is product of two elements of the image. And another example for another situations for say complex semi-simple groups were I think this is around 2003, the Steinberg and Prelate Chatterjee, the independent works. So in the independent works, what they what is shown is that if you take any connected semi-simple algebraic group, and of course it actually is true for arbitrary group, but I'm just mentioning just for simplicity I'm mentioning it for adjoint type, that if you take any connected semi-simple algebraic group of adjoint type and you take power map, so this is power map. So power map is surjective except for some situations. So its power map is surjective if and only if GCD of M and 30 is 1. And if the group is semi-simple but not of adjoint type, then there is some condition involving what is called exponent characteristic and the size of the center. Depending on that, there is some condition, but essentially is this kind of result. So these are some results which are related to power maps. So this was related to power maps, and Borel thing is for arbitrary world. Yeah. Okay. And the way we became interested, I and Anupam, along with some more friends, was while exploring power maps. So one of the exploration which we had about power maps was while we were trying to understand some work of Shalev and others. So here we took finite groups of Lie type of type an and unitary an2, and we could prove that if you have a power map, so you have x1 to the power m, then so this I should have said for, then you can find one integer such that if your group size is exceeding that integer, then the ratio of elements which are in the image of power map is kind of something like 1 by n almost times 1 divided by m square. Yeah, m is this power. And if you take one very special m, some very special choice of m, if you take, then this ratio you can make as small as possible in some sense, because this is 4n by p minus 1. So here you can make p as large as you want, and you can fix the rank. So that way, this ratio could be as small as you want. So all this behaves very abruptly. So in these kind of proofs, what we were really trying to understand was the maximal torus, of course, and how regular semi-simple elements are there. And there are enough regular semi-simple elements, and using those things, we could mix arguments and come up with this. And similar kind of things using maximal torus, we also proved for recently that if you take unipotent groups, so this is the work with the Kundu, Rijabrata, and Anupam Singh. So where you take reductive groups and you take finite groups of Lie type there, and these ratios, the power maps, the how many elements are powers in those groups. So this is set. So we could compute limit points of this set. So this is, there are so many rational numbers, we could compute the limit points of this set of numbers. So this is some general idea about the kind of problems which people look at. So image size is one of the things, and surjectivity, of course, is a part of that. So this is just very, very brief understanding certain special types of words. And the very, very, very celebrated word is a commutator word, x1, x2, so which is x1, x2, x1 inverse, x2 inverse. This was a theorem of Ohr. And as I mentioned, the Goto's paper in the beginning, and that's the main theme of this lecture, and I'll come towards it in the end. So Ohr's paper, which using certain basic observations and the cycle structure of elements of n, it proves that commutators are surjective. So commutator word is surjective. However, for other non-abelian finite simple groups, in fact, maybe I should also mention Thompson's name here. Thompson's name I should also mention here in this. So because of contribution from many people, and last contribution coming from this group, now we have it as a theorem. So commutator word is surjective. So for every non-abelian finite simple group, any non-abelian finite simple group you take, then the commutators are surjective. And this is actually quite tough result, I would say. And a nice survey is there by Gunther Mahle. And maybe one can look at it. And their ideas are very wide. So the ideas in the proof go from as classic statements like this, which is just a statement on character theory and a consequence of, say, sure orthogonality relations. So from sure orthogonality relations, you can count that given a particular element G, in how many ways can you write it as a commutator, in how many tuples, how many g1 comma g2 are there, so that their commutator is equal to g. So this you can use some sure orthogonality relations from that. You can immediately derive, I think you need all characters, all irreducible characters, take all irreducible characters. And then in the paper of these people, Liebig, Obren, Shalev, and Tape, they in fact try to estimate contributions of non-trivial characters in it, and using that they arrive that ng is non-zero in many cases, and they use certain inductive arguments also, and Dalin realistic representation theory, and eventually for smaller cases they also use computer program. So this is quite involved. So even these kind of results, but fortunately now that we have Ohr's theorem. So this uses classic ideas and modern computer theory, Dalin realistic theory and everything. Okay, so these are the kind of results people have been looking at in the word maps. So that was some very, very brief introduction. Of course, I have left many, many important things. There is an entire book which is called Word by Zagel, and there are numerous people like Larson, Schale, many people have been working in these areas. So I can't really cover all that, but that was just to give a basic introduction. Okay, so now I will come to the main theme of this, which is the discussion on Goto's method. So I will first try to describe what is Goto's method, and then we'll see what are the variants of this. And if people are interested, some people are interested, maybe we can talk and I can learn at least more on this, because I have been trying to understand the commutator words, how people have been dealing with. So interestingly, for the power maps, we realized that it's a torus which plays important role, and somewhere I thought that torus may not have much role to play in the commutator maps. But no, now I'm learning from Goto's method that yes, torus has extremely important role in understanding of arbitrary maps, particularly commutator maps, or what are called angle words. Okay, so this is a question which Larson asked in some conference 2008. So question is quite basic, but in its totality, I don't think it is answered. It's only partially answered. So you take the group SUN of special unitary matrices, and you take a non-trivial word, and question is about search activity. Or if you want, you can ask, maybe perhaps when n is large enough, or put some restrictions and ask for search activity. So that is Larson's question. In general, it's very difficult to say about arbitrary words. And of course, we have Borel's dominance theorem, but on the other hand, these other types of extreme results also exist. So I'm just giving you a glimpse of that. So if you fix one N and you take a neighborhood of identity for SUN, so fixed N and neighborhood of identity for fixed N, then you can find some word. You can always find some word whose image is contained within that chosen neighborhood of identity. So it could be that restrictive, that small in some sense. So this could be quite arbitrary. Okay, so now I come to the main theme of today's discussion, which is the variant of Goto's method, which is used to prove Larson's question for infinitely many n. And
before you proceed, there is a question seems from Rajat. Would you like to take this question now?
Yes, if I can answer it quickly, yes.
No. It was my mistake.
No problem. Yeah. Okay. So let's refresh our understanding of SUN before we apply the Goto's method. So I take in SUN this diagonal group. So these special unitary matrices which are diagonal, e to the power I theta 1, I theta 2, I theta n. So this is the unit, this is the condition that summation is zero because determinant is going to be one. And this nature of this e to the power I theta is diagonal, this kind of element because of unitary condition. So this is maximal torus. And corresponding Karna algebra is just I theta 1, I theta 2, I theta n. And condition is of course same. Here also I had written additively. So the same condition. So this is maximal torus. This is corresponding Karna subalgebra. So what else we refresh? Yeah, we also have this exponential map. So this exponential map is from the Lie algebra of SU to the SU. And at the restricted level of Karna subalgebra and torus, also we have exponential map. we can think of this diagram, maybe this diagram. So this is a while group NT by T. NT by T is a while group, and it just permutes diagonal entries. So all those eigenvalues, they are just permuted by the action of NT or action of SN. So that's SN is there. So when I have an element T in the while group, so here it goes to, so S goes to TST inverse. And here at the level of Lie algebra, I have the adjoint map. And here I have exponential map. So with this, I should be able to say lot in case of SUN. Okay, so this map, which is ADT. So what is T? T is an element in the while group. And adjoint is at the level of Lie algebra. And I can extend it linearly to the real group algebra here. And all endomorphisms here, of course. So R, yeah. So here is an observation, which is essentially because of certain surjectivity and divisibility properties of torus. So what is the observation? Observation is that if I take, so F2 is free group on two generators. F21 is the first commutator. F2. So I have a group which is not a commutator, which is not in the first commutator group. Then surjectivity is free, essentially free. That's what it says. It is just a matter of observing. It is just a matter of chasing. It is just a matter of making appropriate chase in this diagram to conclude that any arbitrary word which is not in the first commutator is surjective. So let me try to demonstrate that. The demonstration is that if you take any arbitrary group, if you take any arbitrary word, so any arbitrary word is going to look like this. Yeah, various choices of NIs and MIs, and I'm taking rank 2 free group. My word is having 2 variables. And my choice of word is outside the commutator. So both of them cannot be zero simultaneously. Both of them are not going to be zero simultaneously. Otherwise, all the indices, individually indices, both the indices will add up to zero and my word will actually land in the commutator group. So both of them are not simultaneously zero. So suppose this is good enough to assume that one of them is non-zero. So I assume that this is not zero. So what happens in that case? So suppose summation is equal to R, which is non-zero quantity. And then what I would say is that for surjectivity, it is enough to show that torus is lying inside SUN, because any other elements are conjugate, and word image, as in the beginning I mentioned, is invariant under conjugation, is invariant under, in fact, all automorphisms. So it is enough to push this maximal torus inside the image. Okay, so that's what I do. I pick G, which is there in T, and it is immediate. It's not difficult that this G is actually of the form H to the power R. What is R? R is this. Yeah, R is the summation of all the indices. So essentially, you're reducing the problem to the problem of a power map. Yeah, so if you want me to be precise here, that what choice of H will work, so you can mention it as this diagram. So if I pick an element G, if I take an element G, you can go to G tilde, yeah, which is the pre-image, and that's the Lie algebra. You can just divide by R inside this real Lie algebra. You can multiply by 1 by R in this Lie algebra and take the exponent, take the exponential map, and that H has the property that when you substitute in that word, because I'm putting for the second variable 1, so that will collapse, and what this word will eventually become is just the summation of, it will just become the power map. So because of that collapse, once you put 1, once you are substituting 1 in that, the word map is essentially like x to the power summation ni, right? So that is just x to the power r. This is just a power map essentially, and that's what it becomes. So I hope that is clear to us. So if in SUN, W surjective if my word is outside the commutators. But that is not the point of the Goto's map, Goto's method. Goto's method is about the situations when your word map, your map is say commutator, for example. So for this, I will demonstrate, and then we'll see how carefully people have observed this method, and they have come up with the interesting results. So statement is that if you take commutator word x1 x2 commutator word, and you take SUN, any n, there is no restriction on n, you take any n, then you have surjectivity. And the method is quite elegant, classic, and interestingly, after 50-60 years of that method, people are now observing that what are the lessons to learn from this. Okay, so here it is. You pick this special element. Perhaps this should be called a Coxeter element, and Coxeter element for the reason that it is product of distinct reflections. Yeah, and this idea is actually used, this product of distinct reflections. If you pick, they may help in their conjugacy classes may help in understanding word images. So this particular cycle, n cycle, we pick from the while group. This is the while group in the context. Then sigma minus one, or edge sigma minus one, when you treat it as an element of this endomorphism thing, that is actually an automorphism, that is invertible. That is to be checked, which is not difficult to check, because you can just quickly compute eigenvalues of this, which turn out to be non-trivial nth roots, non-trivial nth roots of one. This is not a difficult computation. So these are eigenvalues of edge sigma, of edge sigma. And one is not there in the eigenvalues. So from that, you can conclude that this is invertible. So concluding that if you pick carefully pick an element in the while group, then the sigma minus one, so this is this very special situation. So sigma minus one edge of that is invertible. Okay, that is first observation. And how do we make use of this invertibility? Perhaps through these diagrams we can understand. So I have
Anirban has a question probably.
Yeah, Anirban.
Amitji, what is the notation at sigma minus one? What is this notation?
Okay. So we have this adjoint map. We have adjoint map at the level of Lie algebra. See, I had mentioned in some diagram. So here I had mentioned this. So at the Lie algebra we have adjoint map. So you just subtract the additive. You just subtract the identity map. Where is that?
Okay.
Yeah. You just subtract the identity map.
Okay. So this.
See, I am treating sigma in R S N.
Okay.
So, and that's what I said.
Okay,
I have explained. Yeah.
Yeah. And one more thing, this while group of SUN will be SN minus one, no? Or because the torus is dependent on N minus one many.
Yeah. No. So what I'm saying is, look here. The only thing right now I'm concerned with is that the permutation.
So
you're
just taking an SN action on this torus, which has n many entries.
I'm taking SN action. Right. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, because your condition is coming, right? So yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I just wanted to write that this element is for better writing. Actually, that's all. Yeah, because I'm picking an element x. 1, 2, 3 and yeah, so I pick an element sigma in the while group, so I should carefully write it. So I'm picking element from the SN. Yeah, so here if I just look at this diagram, the way I would do is maybe I should start from here. Yeah, I think this is I think this is better to start from here. So I have to push this G inside the image. I have to show that this G is a commutator. So I go under the exponential map backwards. So exponential map is surjective. So that is another thing. So surjectivity, these kinds of surjectivities could also be useful. So this is there. And my map, which was there, edge sigma minus one, I have shown that it is invertible. So I can lift it. So I can lift it all the way here because of invertibility of this, because of analysis of eigenvalues of this. This is invertible, and I have h tilde here, right? And I push this h tilde to some element of t. And then just in order to finish the diagram, the only choice which will be available from here to here is the sigma s, sigma inverse s inverse. So sigma is my that corresponding to edge sigma. So at the level of corresponding tori, this edge sigma minus one after exponentiation translates to sigma s, sigma inverse s inverse. So sigma can also be thought here. Sigma can also be thought here as an element of t. Well, I should be somewhat careful in saying that because so after all this, you can check that you have a lift of this. You have a lift of this under the map, which is sigma. This map, which I have written here, sigma s. So this map, under this map, G has been lifted there, and that's what is the commutator, the surjectivity of the commutator map, right? And of course, one has to be careful because the sigma as such may not lie in SU, but you can adjust it by multiplying with suitable elements. Yeah, you can just multiply with the e to the power I pi by n, and that's how it will be pushed inside SUN if required. So if required, so if, of course, the requirement will come when the cycle is having the signature minus one, right? So that is when n is even, you just make that adjustment. So this is just one rough observation of what idea is there in the Goto's proof. And the remark would be that there is something much more which has been proved in the process. We have actually proved that there is a conjugacy class, right? Namely, conjugacy class of one very nice element which corresponds to 1, 2, 3, n. Right, this conjugacy class. So this is one element in the conjugacy class of sigma. This is another element in the conjugacy class of sigma. Right. So sigma or some variant of sigma. Right. So there exists a conjugacy class such that the square of that class, that means you pick some element from this class and you pick another element from the class, the product is equal to SUN. Yeah, so this is somewhat more than what was expected. So this is more which has been proved in the process. Okay, so what is the summary of all this? Yeah, the summary is, and that summary is important. So what's the message? You find suitable element and yeah, maybe by abuse of language, I'm just calling it sigma. You take suitable element sigma and you take suitable polynomial such that add of P sigma is automorphism of this Karna algebra. To find suitable thing. And in our case, just now the proof that we finished, these two were choices for polynomial and the element of the Weyl group. Okay, so we have this. So how can you continue? That means perhaps in some situations, if you can cook up nice elements like this, you will go through with these arguments. With essentially this argument, you will go through. And the way to construct PT will be that for a given choice of word, you associate some polynomial to it. And then you put some conditions if required to ensure this kind of invertibility of the corresponding transformations. Yeah. So there in this, now we just focus on the words which are commutator. Okay, what is being done here? We are constructing polynomials to a word. So to a word in the commutator, first commutator, we are associating a polynomial. So how are we doing it? So first point for reminding is that the first commutator is of course a free group, is a subgroup of a free group, but you can also write down all the generators of this free group. So it is freely generated by these kind of generators, x1, n, x2m, where n and m are non-zero integers. So a typical element, let's say in F2, will look like this. A typical element where these epsilon i's are plus one or minus one. Yeah. So the polynomial which is being attached is this. And we'll try to see why this polynomial is a suitable polynomial. So this is the polynomial. Okay. And this idea is the Elkasapi and Thom. They are just making this variation in the Goto's method. So if you associate this polynomial, and if the condition about invertibility will come from that these polynomials over those eigenvalues. So these polynomials over those eigenvalues are having values non-zero for every L, and then the surjectivity holds, and the choice of sigma remains the same. Here choice of sigma remains the same. So for the same choice of sigma, you can carefully choose certain polynomials so that the Goto's method goes through, and the kind of motivation could come from some diagram like this, where if you make this kind of computation for some while group element, maybe you take this as torus element, or sorry, normalizer of torus element, so W sigma H, if you calculate for that particular word in the commutator, and from that in the computation, the way expressions come up, it is somewhat natural to take that particular choice of polynomial. Okay, so anyway, there is some choice of polynomial which works for the words which are taken in the first commutator group. So of course there will be limitation of this method, namely if your word is actually coming not from the first commutator, further if it is coming from the second commutator. In that case, by the very nature of our association, for second commutators, this polynomial is going to be zero polynomial. Well, primarily because the target is this is abelian. I am just having it as an abelian group, right? So for all the second commutators, this is going to vanish. So therefore, for second commutators, we can't, of course, forget such expectation. The polynomial is identically zero. Yeah. So these kind of things will not work even for the second commutator. So that is the serious limitation of such method. But nevertheless, it's interesting to think about such methods. And there are some compromises where even for the second commutator also things go through, but with some small compromise. So here the compromise is actually coming on the values of n. So what kind of compromise is this? So if you take arbitrary word, so if you take arbitrary polynomial in the domain in which you are considering polynomials, and if k is highest degree, so highest degree of this expression and lowest degree of this expression minus of that, so the span, the entire degree span of this, and then using some number theoretic arguments, we can prove that if some nth root, if some nth root which is some nth root different from one is a root of this P. So this is P. This is PT. Then the lowest prime factor, then the smallest prime factor of n minus 1 is at most k. K is this quantity. So this is some small number theoretic argument. And if you take that argument, and then you go back to Goto, and then you will be able to demonstrate that if the lowest prime factor, so you just take the converse of it. If lowest prime factor is greater than or equal to k, then there is no danger from this condition side. There is no danger because nth roots are not going to be the roots of this polynomial. Nth roots of unity are not going to be root of this polynomial, and therefore the entire argument goes through. So therefore, even for second commutator, so for every element which is in the first commutator, including the ones which are in the second commutator also, this goes through. So that therefore proves that, because these are infinitely many elements, therefore for arbitrary word, infinitely many SUN, so for infinitely many n's, the SUN is the surjectivity is what you are getting. Yeah, so that is one thing, and maybe I'll soon stop here. They also talk about angel words. And the way to deal with angel words is that they compute these polynomials with respect to some other choice of expression, with some other choice of basis of groups, basis of free groups. Okay, so what are angel words? Angel word, of course, starts from commutator, and x1, y1 is x1. And then you have x1, y1 like that. So this is, okay, so I'm having double notation. So this is actually, y1, so this is y1, this is y1, this is x1. So I'm just using two notations. So this is whatever is the previous stage, and take commutator with y1. So these are called angel words, and what they do is they compute the polynomials for these words in terms of some other basis, in terms of some basis, and these turn out to be the polynomials for those particular words, and these polynomials certainly are not having non-trivial nth roots of identity as their roots, and therefore for all angel words, we get the surjectivity of the surjectivity with respect to SUN for all the angel words. So this is kind of a variation of Goto's method, which actually goes through, thanks to the fact that there is a way of assigning some polynomial and putting and analyzing the conditions which are naturally arising in the context. So this is one direction in which Goto's method has been used, and other direction where Goto's method has been used is also for angel words. But that is in the specific situation. Well, that previous one was also a specific situation. So this is a specific situation where you have a simple algebraic group, which is R anisotropic. So algebraic group maybe could be over C, but it is R anisotropic. And there they carefully choose some Coxeter element, and Coxeter elements act with some, well, they act on the Carnot subalgebra without fixed points, and then with some arguments they show that these Coxeter elements as such, if you take the corresponding angel word, and then you have certain kind of surjective over algebraic closure. So this is another direction where the Goto's method has been used, by carefully picking up elements. Here again, they are Coxeter elements arbitrarily, and this is due to Gordiev, 2014. So yeah, maybe I'll just stop with this, and we can discuss.
All right, thank you, Amit, for this very nice talk, and it is time for interaction.
Yeah. Yeah, perhaps I was a bit fast or slow, I don't know.
You are on time.
I'm on time. Okay, thank you. So do we have some discussion?
Yes. Are there questions, comments, suggestions?
I just wanted to ask if possible.
Yes.
So the methods look very specific to real numbers. Is there must be some generalizations possible for arbitrary fields? Maybe for split groups.
For arbitrary fields, I have not seen this. Yeah, for arbitrary
because
fields.
For algebraic groups, I know such results existed long time back. I forget the references now. There are results.
Yeah.
Like every element is a commutator in a simple algebraic group, I think, or an algebraically closed field. So
Right.
That's the result of Poisson, CR and
Ri. Sorry?
That's the result of Poisson, CR and Ri.
It must be very old result, right?
Okay. Okay.
Poisson, CR, Wang and Ri prove that for complex algebraic group, the commutator on word map is adjective.
Yeah, but I think right. Even for general fields, this result is true, but I forget the reference.
No. This is, this is,
uh-huh.
I don't think this is for general field. I mean, this is, even Poisson, CR, Wang, Ri results is very, very, very computational kind of thing.
I see.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I was just wondering, these results, these methods look very specific to use
complex
numbers.
That is right.
It looks very involved also. So I wonder how much of this can be
Yes.
Actually, it is a strange situation that for SLNC, the word map is by Goldstone, the word map is has dense jurisprudence image, but while a compact form, you can choose the word for which. And to the neighborhood, as Amit suggested, that as a result of by Tom.
Take a
neighborhood by identity, then you can choose a word very deep inside the commutator.
Yes.
Which has the image inside, the entire image is lying inside the open set. While if you go to the closure of this, like SLNC, then
yes.
The image is very large. It's a very strange phenomenon, actually.
Right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
Any more questions, comments?
Yeah, so I think all the techniques are different as your word changes, as your group changes, because people coming from finite groups of Lie type, they will use certain kinds of techniques, and there are some people who would use a lot of character theory techniques and lots of computational, literally computation is also going on in some of the computations. So techniques
are
very...
Specific reason for ZTT inverse, any philosophical reasons?
Nothing as such. Yeah, that's the.
Reminds us of a torus. That's why.
Yeah. No, you're just trying to do something. You're trying to do something with the element of the while group in some sense. You are polynomializing the that and seeing that in place of sigma minus one, if some other algebraic expression could be helpful. Because words, in some sense, will translate to some certain algebraic expressions. So the philosophy could be perhaps that any conjugation kind of thing, you do it in some polynomial way, and then it will look like arbitrary word, roughly saying. So you translate it in terms of Lie algebras or H and like that. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
Rahul. There is a question, I think.
Rahul?
Yes, Rahul. There is a hand raised from Rahul Kaushik.
Okay.
I think his microphone may be muted.
Yeah, I see. Yeah,
he can unmute himself.
Yeah. Maybe I can stop share.
Yes.
See people. Now I can see people. Okay.
Yes, Rahul.